Covering the topic of algorithmic complexity and what are the different types of complexity later on that. So take the example of graph. Is this graph is visible to you? This bicolor graph. What is this kind of graph is? Have you seen this? What is this graph? Anybody can. What is this graph? Simple graph. Diagraph. What is diagraph? What is die? Direction. Die for? No. Color. Die for?
Direction.
Direction. So, and extending, what is there? It's a diagraph. And what is this? 2, 3, 4, 5.
Weight.
Weight. Yes. It is a diagraph. It is a weight. So, how to get the complexity of this graph? This, most of the mathematical problem, nature's problem, whatever you can see, we can put it in a this kind of graph. Not everything you can put it in a stack and solve it. Yeah, certain mathematical formula, you put in positive from, you put it into a stack, push pop, you can get an answer. This is if you can write your formula in positive format. That is what we generally inline formula we use. But if we have learned in the, from our childhood that postscript is better, so probably you all agree postscript is a better for computer for ourselves. You don't need bracket. Okay, so that you can solve this problem by postscript notation and using stack machine. So not all problem can be solved by a stack. So there are lots of problems are there, like you know Facebook. So how many of you are friends? How many of you have Facebook? Nobody uses Facebook here. Anybody uses Facebook and now the Facebook is the problem. You are not using Facebook.
Using.
You are using. I know. But anybody is there who is. Who is not using Facebook? Oh, everyone is Facebook. Okay. Actually, how many of you are friends with each other? Not everyone is friends with each other. How many? Everybody? And what is the largest size of group? It is, I will get you my questions. My question is a little bit more complex and complex. What I say that how many of your class, section A and section B together have Facebook? Okay. Now I want the largest size of the group who are friends with each other. Are you getting? This question is not very simple. Maybe he, she, so I want everybody is friends with everybody. What is the largest size? You calculate it, it will never be 120. I can guarantee. It will be much, much less. Maybe 10 or 20 or 30. Who are friends with each other? Do you know what is the problem is? What is the name of the problem? And that is one of the most computer intensive problem and it is a very tough problem. It cannot be easily solved. You have to physically go each and whether we have to check that he or she is a friend. That is the problem. It is called click problem. Click. That is a problem. C-L-I-Q-U-E. And that is one of the hardest problems in computer science. The maximum size of a group who are friends with each other. That is called quick problem. Okay, so problem cannot be defined like number of you are having a 1000 number to solve. So you can say my problem size is 1000. Now you are saying 1 million number to solve. You say my problem size is 1 million. It is easy, one dimension. But it may be multi-dimensional. Right? In the graph, it is not only a diagram. It is also a weight is there. I am getting my problem and I can have more and I am making maximum click or as B. So it is not simply number. What I impress upon to you see that it is not a simple N number. It is a complex problem. So in life there are lots of complex problems. But anyway, if we all complexity here is a dimension is a complexity, weight is a complexity. If you compress it in one dimension, if you could, then it is better we measure the complexity by one dimensional, that is weight. But what I am to impress upon you, it cannot be single dimension. All computer science problems cannot be like sorting and searching. Sorting is a single dimension problem. But single dimension problem is rare. That most of the problem is can be solved by graph, bi-directional graph, maybe three-dimensional graph, maybe multi-dimensional graph, multi-weighted graph, and you can solve the problem through this and through various matrix operation, linear algebra. Then everything cannot be solved by a single dimension. But anyway, we consider it a single dimension. Okay. Now, most of the operation, any operation, like push, pop, something into array, this operation doesn't take only constant amount of time, maybe multiple, but it doesn't need more recursion. So it is O1. Because its worst case time complexity is O1. So if you consider bigger is the maximum. Okay, carry on. So make a pause.
So what is big O?
What is big O? Okay, I'll know. Okay, so any problem. So what is the very first part of the lecture I say? That not everything of the complexity of the problem should not be done, cannot be done in one dimension. A. Because there are many such problems, like I told you with a die graph, with make a die graph, say, and with most of the problems we can find it out, it can be put on a graph. That is the reason graph is very interesting topic, graph theory. So in your second year class, you will get an introduction to data structure and graph is there. There you have to know a graph, how to quickly traverse in a graph in a minimum path, shortest path, and
express theorem.
Like this. How can I make a tree in a graph that it touches every point, that is called minimum spanning tree. Minimum spanning tree. So lots of interesting problem in a graph. Through graph you can solve a lot of problems. Then if you add graph complexity, you can have two-dimensional, bidirectional, weighted graph. Then we can have a three-dimensional graph, more dimension to the graph. Okay, so we can have can solve these various linear algebra matrix multiplication. So even all these things can be compressed. So we can buy a technique, say mathematical, compress to single dimension. Difficult. So then the input size is the main factor for how much time the your algorithm will take. The first thing is the programming language doesn't what all we have about. That as a computer scientist you must know by your heart that it should not depend any programming language. Any good programming language. All programming languages give certain other benefits. Some programming language will give benefit to easier coding, like Python. You can program very easily. Number of lines will be kept. Less. And some programming, if you give open source, it will help. Some programming language, say C hash, it will make you program in iOS platform. So if you make it Java, then it may be Android, it will be friendly. So like this, the programming language, it depends on which environment you are running and who are using. And if you say you want to use a device drive, say you want a new device, you want to be different, then the C is the best choice or the only choice. So programming language doesn't give any advantage for algorithm complexity. That's thing. And algorithm complexity is the paramount interest. And but the performance is that if in C your code runs say 5 seconds, and if you run in a Python, it may be 8 seconds. And it will be very much linear. Okay. So it doesn't mean extra. The main is the size. How much size? Whether you are sorting a 100 number, a 1,000 number, or 1,000,000 number. And you should always give a big size and see the that is the how which algorithm is better. And it can be written in any language, but everybody give equal chance that you should write. So what is her question is what is big O? Big O means say this is your size. I am putting the size of the problem. Size of problem. So size of problem, I make it in one dimension. It is difficult, but if I can put it, the size of the problem is the most important point for guessing how much time the computer will take time. If you get a good algorithm. So if you get a good size of the problem, I put it in a one. And here, say this is our bargain, the black one. This is the same, it comes in the black. So what is the characteristic of the red? Red means after some point, it is always upper than your red, green, black one. Black one is actual. Black one is actual. Yeah, black one is actual. Black one is actual. Black one is the actual time. Black one and red one is always after something red. You know, then after something is always red. So what is the red? Red I call is always, it cannot be lower than your actual operation black. So I can call red is a big go. That is, it is always give the worst case scenario. Now the big O, if you say this is a big O time, this is the worst case. And if you go to the green one, say it is always side by side, it will call average. It sometimes goes below black, sometimes goes upper black. So that is called big theta. And lower one, another lower one, say if you say lower one, say like in a blue, hopefully blue, it is always lower. It is called big theta. So it cannot lower than big theta, lower than theta. So we forget about lowest boundary. We always consider the upper boundary of our complexity and average. Average also generally don't go. We go for big O. Big O means after some operation we can say that is always the upper bound of your complexity. Mr. please ask question. Otherwise, you have understood and answered my question. What is big O? Come. What is big O and big theta? He also comes. Yeah.
Okay. Sir, time complexity and space complexity can be measured when the multiple algorithms are available.
No, I'm not coming to space complexity right now. I'm saying time complexity. Any more question, Muskar? Big O? Is clear? Big O? What is big O? Big O is the worst case. It cannot go your time complexity after sometimes it cannot go over the red one. Red one is the big O. And the black one is actual. And the green one is average. So we forget about big theta. Nobody asks you big theta. Okay, always a big one means worst case time analysis.
Sir, why we are only considering the worst case? Why
worst case always, because we engineers are always supposed to be doing worst case. You cannot go to the best case. Best case, nothing happens in life. You are always prepared.
Idle situations are rare.
Yes, you always take the worst case. Then you can guarantee that this will go to the this time. If it's a worst case analysis, is always a, sometimes you go for average. Sometimes, very few times. Okay, have you understood big O? Questions. Okay. This is your n squared loop within a loop. Loop within a loop within a loop, n cube. Now, you are getting. And you make it a transfer. Should I continue?
Yes.
Okay. So, coming back to this, big O, one is anything, any constant operation, push, pop, finding an element, an array and all this is independent of the number of elements, big O one. And routine is testing a prime number. Testing a prime number means we should divide it by till routine. Till divide up to routine. So complexity is routine. Then the n is any loop, 1 to n, any loop operation. Why is the log n comes? Log n to the base 2. When you're looping and your looping is always divided by the by 2. That is log n to the base 2. So if you see the binary search, if it is your elements in a sorted way in a binary search tree, we can find any element in the log n time. If it is sorted in a binary search tree, because we always go to the midpoint and see, compare my element and midpoint. If my element is bigger, then we go to the right hand side. And right hand side, again the midpoint. Again, bigger, more right hand side. That way, your search in the domain divide by 2. This type of scenario, the complexity is log n to the base 2. If the search the space, divide the space by 3, then it will be log n to the base 3. But hardly it will come. Generally, log n to the base 2 is there. Trying to this way, that is the home task, how to get log n scenario, think scenario, ask, go Google or internet to find that this kind of case, n square is loop within a loop, n cube is a matrix multiplication loop within a loop, n square your bubble search is n square algorithm. So these are the mainly time complexity. Most of the cases we are considered the time complexity. But sometimes space complexity is also required. Can you give an example where you should consider the space complexity? Where? also consider of a how good your algorithm is. You design an algorithm. The most of your computer science career, if you come to the theoretical computer science or even in industry, your lifetime will be next 20 to 30 years go for writing algorithm. And unfortunately or fortunately for us, teaching you this. The most of your computer science career is nothing but testing algorithm, coding that algorithm, verification of algorithm, whether algorithm is true or not, whether it cater all types of cases or not, what is the complexity of algorithm, what is the time complexity, what is the space complexity. When you should go for space complexity? Are you getting my point? When you go for space complexity? Yes. How much extra space is required when it is running time? Whether think of your program is running on a unattended embedded system in rovers in Mars. So you cannot have a direct access. So you also consider that your program should not take much amount of RAM space. You should take minimum amount of RAM space to do the things. So you must also have a count. It should not, because if more RAM space is required, then it must release the space for other programs to run. Because not only your program is running on the cloud, because there are other many programs are running. If you take too much space, then other programs' performance may be bad. So you should also consider how much extra space. Say, in your mobile, if you have, somebody has your 4GB phone, somebody has 8GB phone, our madam has 8GB phone, I have unfortunately 4GB phone. How many of you have 8GB phone? Nobody. So, how many of you have a 4GB phone? Everybody. How many have a 2GB phone? Yeah, he must be crying. 2GB phone, nothing for me now to do with him. Everything, if you want to log in one program, other program object. So, your memory is a crucial thing. So, if you want to buy a laptop, see, go for an 8GB or 16GB. So, RAM should be important concept. So, you should also think about the space complexity. Now, amortized complexity. I have explained again and again. Can anybody tell the amortized complexity? Muskan? Amortized? I have explained. Mehuni Mekhwanan ki? Meghali? Meghali? What is the meaning of Meghali? Don't know. Change your name. Mehuni Mekhwanan name. Meaning of name. Okay, what is the... What is this?
Lifetime program.
Huh? Lifetime program. LIC. What you are telling? If a program runs for full lifetime, average of the worst cases. That is the best expected time. Worst case is, if you take the worst case, it always gives bigger number. If you take the average case here, big theta, that is also not truthful. And amortized means when the algorithm runs for its lifetime. Lifetime in all sets of data and from start to finish, for all sets of data, then the average of worst cases is the amortized complexity. It is a bit tough. So if you please try to get the idea, I'll give you more example. Amortized complexity, whenever you go to second year, third year, there was such a this algorithmic class, then you will be more. But it is better you should know this stuff. Amortized complexity means the average of the worst cases. And that is the most truthful picture of the time complexity of an algorithm. Not always big theta. Big theta is the next best. But big O is the next best. Big theta generally we do not consider. We consider amortized and big O. Okay. And what is energy complexity? Think of it. How many of you have know any of your relative with a pacemaker? Anybody with a relative pacemaker? Yes. So pacemaker, no, you have a battery there, and it has to be battery has to be tuned maybe after 1 year or 2 years. So you should write your algorithm so it should not take too much energy of your battery. Why? If it's to take too much energy, your battery has to be replaced. Instead of 1 year, it may be 3 months. Okay, that's one. And another important thing, if it is taking too much battery energy, then it will generate heat to your heart and that will maybe damage the muscles. So we should also think that it should take less energy. So that like in a pacemaker, like in an unattended
station where have a ad hoc network with a minimum battery, we should also consider how much energy. So these are the more advanced thing, but you also must know the data and amortize functions. Any question you can ask, right? Any question on algorithmic complexity or anything else? I expect a question from at least everybody. You have a question? No question. No question, and then you have not understood that anything. Any question? Then in my WhatsApp group, in our WhatsApp
sir,
group, lots of questions. Yeah.
So in space complexity.
Yeah, this.
So in space complexity, how does it affect the space? Means how much space is usually required? How can we calculate that?
Yes, a good question. First of all, it will be specific. How much space? Because if you don't need any other space, see, we want to transfer a variable, say a variable A, say a register is there A, and another register is there B. You want to swap the values. Are you getting, Neville, are you getting this? You have two registers A and B. You want to swap the values. Say, here it is. Say, I write it here. Say, here I write the register A. And I write it here, register B. Register B. And here you have a value, say, 255. And here it is, say, 250. So I want, 250 should come here, 255 should come here. Tell me the space complexity. Are you getting my point? What is the time complexity or the space complexity?
Yes.
Yes. No, I want to bring, I want to swap the values. 250 here, 255. I have, see, for this swapping, I need another space. So whatever algorithm you think, you need another register so that you can store there, then you can shift. So that
so
is the complexity. You need always space. That you have to, sometimes you mean it, sometimes you need. So space complexity means you sometimes need a space for your buffer. So you need, without this extra register, you cannot do. Think of an algorithm like Mars sort, then extended Mars sort, then the big 1 petabyte sorting. You need to have another extra memory to put the divided and conquer. So you need extra space, that is called the space complexity. But in a bubble sort, in a heap sort, you don't need any extra space. Within your array or within the linked list, you can manage. So you don't need, but sometimes this kind of symbol, scenario, you need to have your truncated or divided rule array, you put to in another space. So there it takes your primary memory, and that memory is a costly one, because how much RAM you have, it may be 4 GB or maybe 8 GB, so and there are several programs are running. If you are sorting a petabyte or terabyte data, then if you give a space, that will take considerable time, so space complexity is the next thing. Are you getting my point? So you think that not all algorithms generally take space. But sometimes simple swapping the values, you need a extra register. Same case in certain algorithms, like I remember Mars sort take extra space. Everywhere some algorithms you take extra space. You need the buffer space. You do not take it lifetime. You have to take malloc and then free. Then malloc and calloc, if you need any malloc-calloc operation, you know malloc and calloc, I believe.
Yes.
Everybody knows. So what is run dynamic time? It is not automatic. It is you get the memory on demand basis. But you always have to free this, otherwise that space will be taken. But in Java and Python, they are automatically garbage collected. That is much better. That is, Java and Python is more like an operating system. C is unfortunately not. C, the programmer has to take care of it. So you can get it, then you have to also free. You have to make it free by this. Any more questions? Are you satisfied with the questions? Anybody have any question? No question. Then at the night I get all this confusion. Whenever I say to write down, then you have a question. So first thing, next assignment, anybody write an assignment. That algorithmic complexity. But today's class, you have to submit a 2-page assignment by handwritten. Handwritten, and that should be fixed up. 2 to 3 page, what is algorithmic complexity, time complexity, space complexity, amortized. Yes. Any questions on this? Quantum analysis, you write it, you will not do it. You go to Wikipedia, everything, algorithmic complexity, the model. It's independent of programming languages. And one question that I found in a group, how to write a pseudocode. What is pseudocode? Pseudocode is nothing but you can learn by Python. Python is a good alternative to pseudocode. Actually, Python is a pseudocode, but Python you have to write less, so that way you can learn Python and pseudocode together. Pseudocode is nothing, it is not a programming language, it is English like construct, but that can be 1:1 mapping by a programming language. Are you getting my point? You are not writing include standard io.h, I mean printf, but instead of printf, you can write print or out. Somebody may question this, print or out. Print will do. So pseudocode, it is so that every pseudocode can be converted to programming language 1:1 or 1:1. Okay. It is the English sentence. For pseudocode, you can follow the Python, yes. For what comes, they are coming, this topic, they are coming.
What is the topic of algorithmic complexity? And what are the different types of complexity? Later on. So, take the example of graph. Is this graph is visible to you? This bicolor graph? What is this kind of graph is? Have you seen this? What is this graph? Anybody can, what is this graph? Simple graph? Digraph? What is digraph? What is di? Direction, die for, not direction. Color, die for?
Direction.
So, and extra thing, what is there? It's a diagraph. And what is this? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Weight.
Weight, yes. This is a diagraph. It is a weight. So, how to get the complexity of this graph? This, most of the mathematical problem, nature's problem, whatever you can see, we can put it in a this kind of graph. Not everything you can put it in a stack and solve it. Yeah, certain mathematical formula, you put in positive from, you put it into a stack, push pop, you can get an answer. This is, if you can write your formula in positive format. That is what we generally inline formula we use. But if we have learned in the from our childhood that positive is better, so probably you all agree positive is a better for computer for us also. You don't need bracket. Okay, so that you can solve this problem by positive notation and using stack mission. So not all problem can be solved by a stack. So there are lots of problems are there, like you know Facebook. So how many of you are friends? Or how many of you have Facebook? Nobody use Facebook here? Anybody use Facebook now that Facebook is the problem? You are not using Facebook?
Using.
You are using, I know. But anybody is there who is who is not using Facebook? Oh, everyone is Facebook. Okay. Actually, how many of you are friends with each other? Not everyone is friends with each other. How many? Everybody? And what is the largest size of group? It is, I am getting my questions. My question is a little bit more complex and complex. What I say that how many of your class, section A and section B together, have Facebook? Okay. Now I want the largest size of the group who are friends with each other. Are you getting? This question is not very simple. Maybe he, she, so I want everybody is friends with everybody. What is the largest size? You calculate it, it will never be 120, I can guarantee. It will be much, much less. Maybe 10 or 20 or 30. Who are friends with each other? Do you know what is the problem is? What is the name of the problem? And that is one of the most computer intensive problem, and it is a very tough problem. It cannot be easily solved. You have to physically go each and whether we have to check that he or she is a friend. That is the problem. It is called click problem. Click. That is the problem. CLIQUE. And that is one of the hardest problems in computer science. The maximum size of a group who are friends with each other. That is called quick problem. Okay, so problem cannot be defined like number of you are having a 1000 number to solve. So you can say my problem size is 1000. Now you are saying 1 million number to solve. You say my problem size is 1 million. It is easy, one dimension. But it may be multi-dimensional. right? In the graph, it is not only a diagram, it is also a weight is there. Are you getting my problem? And I can have more, and I am making maximum play or as B. So it is not simply a number. What I impress upon to you see that it is not a simple n number. It is a complex problem. So in life there are lots of complex problems. But anyway, if you all complexity here is a dimension is a complexity, weight is a complexity. If you compress it in one dimension, if you could, then it is better we measure the complexity by one dimensional, that is weight. But what I am to impress upon you, it cannot be single dimension. All computer science problems cannot be like sorting and searching. Sorting is a single dimension problem. But single dimension problem is rare. Then most of the problem is can be solved by graph, bidirectional graph, maybe three-dimensional graph, maybe multi-dimensional graph, multi-weighted graph, and you can solve the problem through this and through various matrix operation, linear algebra. Then everything cannot be solved by a single dimension. But anyway, we consider it a single dimension. Okay. Now, most of the operation, any operation, like push, pop, something into array, this operation doesn't take only a constant amount of time, maybe multiple, but it doesn't need more recursion. So it is O1. Big O is worst case time complexity is O1. So if you consider big O is the maximum. Okay, carry on. So make a pause.